another fear that people have or reaction that people have is that it somehow demeans the savior. Is that like a common reaction?
If you say that, then you might say, well, Joseph Smith impinged on the savior, which is what Christians say about Joseph Smith. And it's a similar reaction, or Moses would impinge on Jehovah. You know, no, the Lord has an end time scenario, and he raises up people, and Isaiah identifies them by name, and they bring to pass all the restoration of the house of Israel, Israel's 12 tribes, and all of the house of Israel, not just the Jews. And there is a whole end time scenario of a worldwide war. A war to end all wars. And there are people involved, the Lord's servants. Not going to happen in a vacuum. And Isaiah identifies this scenario, details it out, and names the players, and names the king of Assyria, the end time Antichrist. It's all there. So the sooner we learn it, because the Lord is going to bring forth other books, you know, that have the sealed portion, for Book of Mormon, for example, the plates of ether that have the vision of the brother of Jared. And those things are called, in the Book of Mormon, the greater things. And yet also Jesus calls the words of Isaiah great. So if we haven't researched those things, then when those things come forth, then we're going to be totally off guard, caught off guard from what we don't know. And so that speaks to the divide that Jesus speaks of. And the end time is not about the divide between President Nelson and the Latter Day David. It's a divide between those who search the scriptures to know these things. As an Isaiah Institute, we're here to bring forth more truth. And it's too bad when people seeing us do that, you know, come down on the messenger. The messenger is Isaiah, and that is what we're helping to make understood. No? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, those are good answers. Really good answers. So what would you say to somebody who said, well, if I needed to know who the Davidic servant was, then the prophet or the apostles, they will tell us. What would you say to somebody who said that?
It's the same question again all over. It all goes back to those who do not keep Jesus' commandment to search the scriptures. And searching is not just studying and reading. It's making a whole endeavor of it to dig deeper and to look up words and concordances and make connections of words and to look and see the many different levels of Isaiah's prophecy. It's talking about, I mean, it deals with literary structures that have their own message over and above what you read on the surface of Isaiah. There's whole typologies involved of 30 ancient events that are going to repeat themselves in the end time. There are wordlings, keywords, and codenames that create a prophecy within a prophecy in the book of Isaiah. And if you haven't paid the price to know those things and just let them go over your head, quite happy to stay in your comfort zone, no wonder you're getting reactions from people like that.
Mm-hmm. So it's just probably not going to happen that way, right? That it's
you're not going to be given it. No, it's not going to come down from the pulpit. Mm-hmm. That's why Jesus makes it a personal challenge. It's never going to come down from the pulpit. We're not going to be, you know, told exactly what to do. It's a slothful servant that needs to be told what to do. If we search the scriptures and we learn these things, we will know what to do because the Lord made us agents in our own right. You know, we are our own agents. And so he expects us to be that and not to be, you know, hanging on someone else's coattails, President Nelson or anybody else. And Brigham Young said as much, don't hang on our coattails. Learn these things for yourself.